You remember coming down there, before I was out of my time, to ask after a vagabond that had bolted off, and left his disconsolate father a prey to the bitterest emotions and all the rest of it, don't you?' said Mr. Tappertit. "'Of course I do,' cried Hugh. "'And I saw you there.' "'Saw me there?' said Mr. Tappertit. "'Yes, I should think you did see me there. "'The place would be trouble to go on without me. "'Don't you remember my thinking you liked the vagabond, "'and on that account going to quarrel with you, "'and then finding you detested him worse than poison, "'getting to drink with you? "'Don't you remember that?' "'To be sure,' cried Hugh. "'Well, and are you in the same mind now?' said Mr. Tappertit. "'Yes!' roared Hugh. "'You speak like a man,' said Mr. Tappertit, "'and I shake hands with you.' With these conciliatory expressions he suited the action to the word, and Hugh, meeting his advances readily, they performed the ceremony with a show of great heartiness. "'I find,' said Mr. Tappertit, looking round on the assembled guests, "'that brother, what's his name, and I, are old acquaintance. "'You never heard anything more of that rascal, I suppose, eh?' "'Not a syllable,' replied Hugh. "'I never want to. "'I don't believe I ever shall. "'He's dead long ago, I hope.' "'It's to be hoped, for the sake of mankind in general, "'and the happiness of society, that he is,' said Mr. Tappertit, rubbing his palm upon his legs, and looking at it between whiles. "'Is your other hand at all cleaner? "'Much the same. "'Well, I'll owe you another shake. "'I'll suppose it done, if you've no objection.'